Hi, who is talking to you right now? The real me or the virtual me? You are actually watching my virtual image talking to you. Now you are seeing the real me, the real object, because the light rays are directly entering your eyes after reflecting from my face. But now you are seeing my virtual image, which appears to be standing the same distance behind the mirror as I am standing in front of it. See, it's going back if I go back, and it's going front if I go front. Now, why do we call this image of mine as virtual? Because it's not real. So when do we call an image real? When it is made by the actual intersection of light rays. The light rays which form this virtual image of me actually appear to diverge after reflecting from the plane mirror and appear to come from a point which is behind the mirror, which is where you see the virtual image of me. Of course, light rays can't be coming from behind the mirror because the mirror is opaque. That's why the image which you are seeing right now is not real and cannot be captured on a screen. Where is my image? How can I capture it on the screen? I can't find it anywhere on the screen. But a real image can be captured on a screen, as you can see here, how the real image formed by this convex lens has been captured on this white screen. In this demonstration here, I have a candle flame, which is a real object, placed in front of a plane mirror, which forms a virtual image behind the mirror, which, as we all know, can't be captured on a screen. Now, is it possible to capture this image of this candle flame on a screen? Of course not, right? Wrong. Let me show you. So this is my candle flame, and this is the plane mirror directly opposite to it, and in front of the plane mirror I have kept a screen, and you can see the inverted image, real inverted image of this candle flame on the screen. Can you see that? So how is this possible? How can a plane mirror form a real image of a candle flame which can be captured on a screen? All of you thought it's impossible, right? Well, so nothing is impossible in this world. But of course, I can't be breaking any laws of physics. So let me explain what I have done. So you have here this candle flame, which is the real object, and the light rays from this candle flame are passing through this convex lens and forming a real image behind on the other side of the lens. But before the real image can be formed, the light rays hit the plane mirror and then bounce back from the plane mirror and reach the screen. And so the real image formed by this convex lens has become the virtual object for this plane mirror. And the virtual object for this plane mirror has formed a real image in front of the plane mirror. Let me now explain how I managed to make the plane mirror form a real image. This candle flame here was the real object which emitted the light rays which were diverging from the real object. But then this convex lens made those light rays to converge again and form a real image. But now, before these light rays could converge and form a real image, I have placed a plane mirror in front of the real image. As a result, the light rays hit the plane mirror and then follow the law of reflection. That is, the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection for both these rays, and as a result they now converge after hitting the mirror instead of diverging as they did earlier. So now, since the light rays converge after hitting the mirror, they meet in space in real manner and form a real image. So now if I place a screen at this location, I will be able to capture this real image on the screen, as you saw in the demonstration.